Hi, welcome back to ODE YouTube channel. My name is Paulo and I'm here again for another pen review. And this time we are reviewing another Caveco pen. This pen was provided to me by Caveco for review purposes. So thank you Caveco for sending me the pen. And let's start. The pen comes inside the typical tin box. And inside, let me put this way, it's more beautiful. Okay, it comes inside the typical tin box with a cardboard, black cardboard sleeve that has these inscriptions. I guess you already know this. It has this box, there's a ding there, and this is a long one because this is the Caveco Steel Supra, or the Supra Steel. The pen comes inside the box with this paper with the history of Caveco and some other informations, the shiny sticker that we all have, lots of them I guess, and also the pen. And this pen is very beautiful. I will not spend too much time reviewing this pen because I already reviewed its brother or sister, the Brass Supra. So, about this pen has the typical cigar shape with rounded ends on this end. It has the Caveco logo, this is the top of the cap, and on the bottom it has nothing except surrounding the bottom. It has threads to be able to post the pen, and that's it. Very simple. You can see a little step here and a little seam there also. Here you have Caveco Supra Germany engraved on the pen, and this is what you can see on the outside. Then you can uncap the pen and you will have access to this very slightly hour shaped section, and you have this beautiful number 6 steel nib marked Caveco and a regular feed, and this feed opposite to the Caveco Sport doesn't have the logo there. The pen is a cartridge converter pen. You can screw it and it takes international cartridges or international converters. The pen overall has the same shape as the Caveco Lilliput. This is not made of steel, this is aluminum, but I don't have a steel one, so just here for comparison. And it is the same size of the Caveco Supra in brass. It is 1 gram lighter, so let me check if I'm saying it right. No, sorry. It is 3 grams lighter than the Caveco Supra in brass. So this is 53 grams and these are 50 grams. So some difference. And it can take also this clip. This is a optional and removable clip. It is available only in this color, which is bronze. It fits quite well on this color, but I prefer to see very simple steel. I like steel pen, so this is beautiful. And like the Caveco Supra, you take some quite turns to uncap it. Let's look at the Caveco there. 1, 2, 3 and half, 3.5 turns to uncap the pen. Now, you have this raised part here because this pen allows you to take this out, to take this part away, and then this will not fit with two cartridges or with a long converter, so you need to remove the extra cartridge. You put it like this and you can use the pen this way. And this is interesting because this way you'll have a pen that is smaller than the Supra in the full size, and it is almost the same size as the Lilliput, but girthier, and this is a nice thing. And it looks very good with its big nib next to Lilliput, and I think this is a beautiful pair. So I think I now need to have that one, the Lilliput, in steel also. Another thing that I want to talk about is about posting the pen. If you use the pen, I'm showing the brass now for simplicity, if you use this pen like this, it is long enough and heavy enough to write without posting. If you prefer to post, this will make the pen to be too long, and I don't think it is that comfortable to write with such, looks like only almost a magic wand. But if you write with your pen this way, it is too short to write comfortably. So what can you do? That is what I like it better. I prefer it to be the short way, and if you, I'm not sure, it depends on the days actually. I'm saying this, but it's not true, it depends, it really depends. If you like to post your pens, I would advise you to write to have the pen this size, the smaller one, so you can post it and it becomes a full size. I think this is the best solution, because if you put the two pieces there, it becomes very, very big. If you prefer to hold the cap in your other hand while writing, that's what I usually do, this is not here, you can put this part and have the end of the barrel, and then you have a full-sized pen that is better to write with, and just hold the cap in the other hand so you don't have an extra long pen. That's what I would do. One thing that I would do also, if I was the designer, if, I don't know if this is possible, I would have this part not to be raised, to be all straight, all flush. That's how I would prefer it to be. So this pen, just for comparison purposes, let's cap it. Here you have it along with the Caveco steel sport, very nice pen. Also, if you uncap it, and if you uncap and post the steel sport, this is how you compare them. So it is a nice size. It is a little shorter. Let's consider that I would write with this one posted, and I would not write with that one posted. The Supra is a little shorter, but it has a bigger nib, so I really enjoy that bigger nib. And something that I want to say also, just for just to complete something, is that the Caveco Steel Sport weighs 41 grams. And so the Supra in steel weighs 50 grams. And if you write in the short way, it is 38, so this is much more heavy unless you take the section or you don't use the cap, so they will be almost the same weight. So it's just a matter of preference, but when you look at these pens, you find them to be almost indestructible. They are really, really nice pens. I really have a crush for the Caveco Sport model, but the Supra is really, really something that I really enjoy. And if you ask me which one of the two I would prefer, I would have no doubt saying that it would be the steel version. Why? Because I like steel better. It's not because of that, but steel will not get any patina. It will be like this, so it is beautiful. But I really like the steel better than the brass. But they are overall the same pen, so Don't think I'm choosing one because it's better. It's just because it's my personal taste. Now, comparing it with the Parker Centennial Blue Fold and a Lamy LX, which is the same size as the Lamy Safari Vista All-Star. The Supra is shorter. If you uncap the Parker Centennial Blue Fold Big Red and the LX Ruthenium and the Supra, let's not post the Supra because I wouldn't post it if it is in the full size. And there you have it. The Supra is just a little bit shorter, but not that much. So I would say they are quite comparable, except for the weight, because this one is much heavier. And that said, let's go to the writing sample. And I'm back with the pen and paper. And just to complete what I said, this pen costs 120 euros. So it's not an inexpensive pen, but you have lots of material here. It is really sturdy, and you have that option of choosing the size of the pen, which is quite good. It's not that cheap for a steel nipped pen, but 120, I've seen really worse than that. I think because of you're paying mostly the sturdiness of the pen. You will not break this. You can destroy the nib, of course, but it's almost impossible to destroy, at least in normal circumstances, to destroy this pen. I think you can go over this pen with your car. It will not be destroyed. If it's kept, of course. So, this is the Caveco Supra Steel, and the paper is the usual Rhodia.pad, and the ink inside the pen is the Pelican Edelstein Aquamarine. The nib on this pen is a fine steel nib. And what do I think about these big number 6 Caveco nibs? I find they are quite soft, and you can see there, you can have some line variation easily without pressing too much. The pen doesn't skip there. It was my fault. I'm just trying to have it very lightly, so I lifted the pen from the paper just to show you the normal line variation. It's not a flexible pen, but you can have line variation, and if you press it a little bit harder, you have more. However, I find these nibs to be quite soft, so be careful not to spring the tines of the nib. Something that is interesting is that when I got this pen, it had a bent nib. I fixed it, Caveco sent me another nib, and I also have the brass version. All of them have the same fine steel nib. So I tried so far 3 different, but also all of them fine, number 6 Caveco nibs. All of them have this kind of property, so I think that's good for consistency. About the line, this is the regular line with no pressure. This is the reverse writing. It's not scratchy. It's really nice, but there is no ink. And this is how it is with some force. And between, so this is with no pressure, and this is with pressure. So there's really some difference there. About the wetness, don't forget this is a fine nib, but I would say this is wet enough. And I'm not pressing now hard, and you can see still a lot of ink laid down on the paper. So this is a really good pen. I enjoy it. So, be careful with the line variation. Don't force it too much. It is already easy to have some line variation because the nib is soft enough and the pen is very heavy. So, it is easy for you to make some natural more pressure when you're writing. If it was a lighter pen, you would not press it so hard, but the actual weight of the pen will force you to put some more force into the nib. So, this pen is really good. I really like it. It will stand even quick writing. It skipped there, but again, I think it was my fault. I don't find this pen to skip, and I've written a lot with it. I'm lucky enough to get to have this pen for myself. So thank you, Caveco. Thank you, Caveco, for sending me this for the review. And this pen is truly good. Thank you all for watching this video. Don't forget to like if you liked it and to subscribe to the channel. And if you like Caveco pens, these ones or others, fountain pens, ball pens, mechanical pencils, vintage, modern, whatever, you can find our group at Facebook, which is a closed group, so private group you can ask to join, and it is called Caveco Collectors and Users. Search for it on Facebook, I will put a link down below, and you can access, and I will allow you to get in if you want to get crazy about Caveco as much as I am. This is all for today. I really hope you enjoyed, and I hope to see you soon in some other video. Bye!